Hey, this is Daniel again with Cable Wholesale. Thanks for joining me today. We're in the middle of a how-to video on using our Cat6 Inline Junction boxes. Like I said, thanks again for joining me today. Let's take a look at what you'll get when you get the product home. All right, so here's our Cat6 Inline Junction box. The part number is 30X8-11100. We're also carrying in a Cat5e version if you're running a Cat5e network. Top comes off here. There are some little tabs on the side. Use a little screwdriver to release that. Comes with two little screws as an optional mounting feature. There's a hole here and here if you choose to use that. It also comes with a little instruction sheet, but hey, you're watching the video, so we don't really need that. Last thing comes with is a piece of double-sided sticky tape, just in case you want to mount it again. It's just another way to possibly mount it. So let's go back to punching this down and showing you the how-to. All right, so we're back. Let's go ahead and finish the install and the how-to on using our junction boxes. Again, you guys stepped in when I was finishing up the first half. The steps are the same for both sides. So first thing you're gonna wanna do is get an Ethernet cable stripper. Go ahead and give it a couple of turns. Remove the outer jacket of your Ethernet cable. For Cat6 cables, they do come with a spline, so we will have to cut that out. To get to it, go ahead and just bend back the four pairs. Get some nice sharp scissors. Go ahead and cut that out. The next step we're gonna have to do is get the four pairs of the eight conductors ready for getting them set up in the proper orientation on the junction box. So let's go ahead and do that now. So now that we've prepped our cable and we removed the outer jacket and removed the center spline, we're gonna get the conductors oriented in the proper positioning. The junction box is clearly marked here in the center with color diagrams, tells you which slot each of the conductors goes into. So I've taken the four pairs here and put them in correct positioning to go into the slots on the junction box. Okay, so what helps me when I'm doing one of these punch downs here is I kind of eyeball the distance from my cut to the positions where the conductors will be punched down. I've already set up the orange and the orange white relatively close, same with the brown. Last ones to do here are to set up my blue conductors and my green conductors. The next step will be untwisting the pairs. All right, so now that we've got these little bends in here, just as a easy guide to where you're gonna have to untwist, it's time to start untwisting these pairs. What I do is untwist them just a little bit further than that little bend that I put in each of the four pairs just a second ago. So putting those bends in each of the pairs really helps here. The next step, which is seating this cable down for the final punch. Kind of makes it nice and easy. You can see that everything's lined up in the proper positioning. So now our last step here is to use the punch down tool. Okay, so the punch down tool does require a little bit of force for it to do its job. For first timers, DIYers, people who aren't using these tools on a daily basis, my suggestion would be to use two hands. First hand would be to hold it in a vertical position. Use your second hand to apply the necessary force to get it to punch down. The flat bottom of the junction box really is helpful in keeping it stable. Again, it's really important to have the tool in a vertical position. Keeps you from, if you come in at an angle, sometimes you can break these little pieces of plastic here. So we are halfway through. We'll go ahead and flip the tool. Again, pointy side is facing out the outside of the junction box. And let's get these last four punches done. So we're just about done here. The last thing we need to do is if you give these tails of the wire, the conductors a little wiggle, they will come off. Almost there. All right, so the last step, we're gonna put the junction cover on. So thanks for joining me again today. Again, my name is Daniel, I'm with Cable Wholesale. Remember, you can find all the products that we use in our demo today on our website, CableWholesale.com. We're available Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. Eastern to 5 p.m. Pacific by live chat or phone. Please give us a thumbs up. Go ahead and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks again.